Good morning, guys. Today I'm here to answer a pretty commonly asked question from Melburnians and tourists visiting Victoria. And it's something that I researched myself before going on this trip. And the question is, can I drive the Great Ocean Road in a day? And while the answer is technically yes, this video is here to give you three reasons why you shouldn't drive it in a day. So let's get into it. So for those who don't know, the Great Ocean Road is a 243-kilometre stretch of road which follows the southwest coast of Victoria. It starts in Torquay and ends in Allensford, although a lot of people kind of keep driving up to Warrnambool as well, which is what I did. And it's basically just a beautiful stretch of road following like a dramatic coastline and winds in and out of the mountains, and there's just so many things to see and do. So it's a very popular place to visit, especially from Melbourne, and a lot of people do wonder if they can do a day trip, which is why I filmed this video. So let's get into reason number one why you shouldn't do it in one day. So reason number one I think is pretty obvious, but you're going to miss out on majority of stops along the way. Now most people go to the Great Ocean Road to see things, to do things, for a getaway, for a beautiful place to go. Not many people actually go just to kind of drive through on the way to somewhere or whatever. So although it is 243 kilometres, there is so many things to stop and do along the way. If you just drove and didn't stop, you could definitely drive the whole thing in a day, but the whole point is really to go there and see the beautiful things that it has to offer. I did it over 4 days, and honestly, like, there's still things that I missed, and I want to go back and stay at more places and see more things, do more waterfalls, more hikes. Like, there's so much more I could have done, which I just didn't have the time for in 4 days. So goes to show just how much there is there and how much is on offer. I spent most of my time doing short walks. There's so many waterfalls, a lot of them you probably heard of, like Erskine Falls, but there's lesser known ones like Hopetoun Falls, Sher Oak Falls. There's heaps more that I didn't even get to go to, along with plenty of, little hikes and short walks and bush walks. There's also great lookouts. There's a good one called Teddy's Lookout in Lawn. There's Mariner's Lookout in Apollo Bay. And apart from that, there's plenty of other things. Like, obviously the beaches are a big attraction as well, especially if you're into surfing or anything like that, or taking the kids for a swim in the summer. There's just plenty of things to see, chocolate factories, wineries, like, you name it, it's there. So it's definitely something that shouldn't be rushed, as I said. 3 or 4 days, probably 3 days, I'd say most people probably do it in. I decided to do 4, and even still, I could have definitely gone for a week, I think. And while planning it, I kind of listed all the stops, but everything just takes longer than you think. Like, you might allow, an hour for a waterfall, and then you want to sit there and enjoy it for longer. So taking your time is definitely the best option for the Great Ocean Road. Obviously, everyone's not as fortunate to have as much time off work and things like that, and time to get away, but just maximise your time there, and for this reason I would definitely recommend not doing the Great Ocean Road in a day. Reason number two why you shouldn't do it in one day is actually the road. Now the road is quite windy, it can be quite steep, quite narrow. A lot of the time we're going quite slow, like, it might be windy corners, but you can only do 40, or especially with other cars as well. So because it is a major tourist attraction, there's lots of people that go there, especially in the summer, like the peak seasons. There's lots of cars constantly pulling over for lookouts to get photos, or there might be wildlife on the road, even cyclists, things like that. Like, there just seems to be a very slow road. And look, it probably is a good thing that the roads are quite narrow and windy and that sort of thing, which does force people to slow down. Because if it was straight and that sort of thing and it was 100, like, obviously it'd be more dangerous for people pulling off to go to attractions and that sort of thing. So just keep in mind that while you're driving, you probably will be going quite slow most of the time. But you've got the gorgeous coastline, like, majority of the way you can actually see the ocean right next to you. So it's kind of nice to be going slow and just to see it and take it all in. It's not something that should be rushed. Although it's only 243 kilometres, like, you might think, okay, that's fine, I can easily do that and back in a day, which you technically can, but you're definitely not going 100 the whole way, so just keep that in mind. And number three is it can be quite dangerous. If you are doing a day trip, say from Melbourne, that's nearly all day in the car. It's a lot of driving. People can become quite fatigued, especially like going around these corners and stuff. You need to be concentrating. And also on the other hand, you want other people to be concentrating because you don't want someone else being fatigued on the other side of the road coming at you or causing a crash. Or there is plenty of other things too, like the weather. It can get quite really windy on that stretch of road. There can be a lot of wildlife on the road. And not so much anymore, but pre-COVID, obviously we had a lot of tourists from other countries which aren't used to driving on the left side of the road. So, I don't know, there's just a whole mix of things which can actually make that road quite dangerous. And I just think to make it safe for everyone, it's just better if you don't do it in a day because, as I said, you will be quite fatigued. And just to make it safe for everyone, just go, stay the night, spend a weekend, if longer, go as long as possible. But keep in mind that it can be a dangerous road as well. If you were, say, headed to South Australia or somewhere else, Warrnambool, you did want to take the scenic way, obviously the Great Ocean Road is a good option. You don't necessarily have to stop if you're just using it as a path to get somewhere else. In that case, you can definitely do it as a day trip and head through straight to Warrnambool or somewhere else. So I'm not saying you can't do it, you definitely can, but if you're doing it to go spend time there and actually see the Great Ocean Road, definitely don't do it in a day. But If you're just passing through, then it is a great option because you get a beautiful view on the way to wherever you are going. If you are really limited on time and you literally only have one day, say off work, or for whatever reason you only have the one day and you don't want to miss out on seeing the Great Ocean Road, then I definitely understand that. You could also look at tour options from Melbourne. I know there's a lot of like tour buses and coaches and stuff that take you down there, and they'll drive you and then you don't have to worry about that. And because it is such a big day, and they do allow for that, they do big days on the trips, but you don't have to worry about driving and being fatigued and all that, so you can sleep on the way or on the way back if you want, or just do other things on the bus. So that is a good option if you do only have the one day. Definitely head down and visit the Great Ocean Road. I had an epic time when I was there, and honestly it exceeded all my expectations. It was something that wasn't even really on my radar that much for Victoria, but it was absolutely beautiful, blew me away. So many waterfalls, so many things to stop and see. Obviously the 12 apostles and all that sort of thing, Gibson Steps. And you really just don't know till you go. Like, there's just turn-offs everywhere to all these different things, and you just don't want to miss out on any of them. So definitely head down. I love the Great Ocean Road, and I hope you have an awesome time. I'll leave my link to my vlog below from when I went. Actually, I think there's four from each separate day, but if you're looking for more in-depth information about what to do and what to see, definitely go check them out, and I'll leave them in the description below. And thanks for watching, guys, and have a good day.